Cosmonaut Quickie!
Now, I was pretty excited for this new Resident Evil 3 remake. Y'all might not know this, but I actually really like Resident Evil. RE4 is one of my top 3 games of all time, and the RE2 remake from last year is amazing. Honestly, it was easily my game of the year. I am not lying. So yeah, when I found out that we were getting another remake just a year later, I was pretty hyped. So did the game live up to my expectations? No, not really. Now, I will say with full transparency that the original Resident Evil 3 is the only mainline RE title that I have never even touched one time. I was going in completely blind. And a lot of people have claimed that the only reason I didn't like this game is because I didn't play the original. But I didn't play most of the original RE2, and I liked the remake a lot, so I don't think it should matter that much. I kinda wanted this to be my first experience with RE3, and I gotta say, the overall experience was kinda lackluster. First of all, this game ain't scary.
These guys aren't scary though, cause like I saw them in the last game.
This game puts a heavier emphasis on action than the last one, and honestly, the action is the thing I like the least in Resident Evil. In most other Resident Evil games, it's impossible to kill every zombie in the game with the resources that you are given, because that's how survival horror works. You have to conserve your resources, and sometimes that means leaving some enemies and hoping that you can just avoid them later. A lot of the later Resident Evil games kinda did away with that, but I'm talking about the early ones right now, the ones that were mostly centered around survival horror. The thing is, this game really drowns you in ammunition and healing items, and I was at no point afraid that I would die from a lack of resources. Back when I played the original Resident Evil 1, I actually couldn't beat my first run because I ran out of items. And I'm not saying that I wanted that to happen here, but I did want the tension to be a little more present. I legitimately never felt like I was in any danger. The enemies also die way faster, and by the last third, I was just mindlessly mowing them down. On top of that, Jill and Carlos have these new moves where they can dodge or do like this haymaker punch, and while those are actually really fun to use, it makes the game a lot easier. My point is that the easier the game is, the less scary it is. It's not as intense because you know you can handle any threat, because you're armed to the teeth. Jill gets so many heavy weapons in this game. Between the shotgun, the grenade launcher, and the magnum, I was never worried about any monster that I encountered. At one point during the stream, I got so bored that I was just punching enemies with Carlos, because I just didn't care anymore. And you know what? I did just fine. Now, this is mostly an issue when it comes to Nemesis, because Nemesis is kind of a pushover. Most of your interactions with him are either in cutscenes or boss fights where things are pretty scripted. And I gotta say, a lot of these boss fights are not very fun. The exception is the first actual fight against him, and actually, the whole first third of the game where he's chasing you through the streets was pretty cool. This is where he's most similar to Mr. X from the last game, but with the ability to teleport and shoot a fucking gun. Basically, whenever Nemesis is wearing his trash bag costume, the game is perfectly fine. I had no complaints about the first chunk of the game, but then he takes kind of a back seat and the tension fades. Because the other villain isn't really that convincing or engaging. As the game progressed more and Nemesis stopped chasing me, I just kinda got bored. I just kinda thought that he was gonna be a more persistent threat. I mean, in the last game, Mr. X would show up all the time, at least in Leon's route. Nemesis doesn't show up for most of the game, which is weird to me. I feel like he was kinda underused. Now, keep in mind, there are a few extra unlockable difficulty modes, and I haven't tried those yet. Maybe that will mitigate the difficulty problem a bit, but I still didn't feel any tension or fear while playing this game, so I don't think that's gonna change. Now, like I said, I really did like the first third of the game. Running around the streets and backtracking and trying to gather every resource is my shit. That's what I play Resident Evil for. Give me a big area with lots of secrets and lots of stuff to find. The RE2 remake does this really well. Resident Evil 7 does it really well. This is the core Resident Evil gameplay in my mind. But once you get past the streets of Raccoon City, this game gets really linear. In Carlos's levels, he usually has just one room that he needs to get into before you switch back to Jill. And then there's a part where you switch back to Jill, you run forward for a minute, and then you do a boss fight, and then you switch back to Carlos. I like it when I have a lot of things to find in these games. Sometimes in Resident Evil, you'll find a super cool hidden gun or upgrade because you thought outside the box or explored every nook and cranny. In this game, a lot of the upgrades are just dropped in front of you most of the time. Like, look at this one. Yeah, that was a real head scratcher, guys. I just had to look behind the desk. I'm not saying that this game is so linear to the point where you're just running down one corridor shooting at zombies. But in this game, if you do go off the beaten path, you'll usually just find a single dead end with maybe like a zombie or two and some spare ammo. I never really felt rewarded for the small amount of exploration I could partake in. A lot of the time, I was surprised to see my map just turning blue and telling me that I had no more items to collect in the area, because I was like, wow, that was it? I could have sworn there would have been more stuff here. However, I will say some positives, because I didn't hate the game, I don't think it's a bad game, and on a presentation level, this game is bananas. The RE engine is insane. This game looks so good. I was almost tricked into not being too mad at the game because it looks so amazing. Another thing I really liked in this game was the soundtrack, which is kind of surprising. The last game did not have a ton of songs, but the few that were in that game were fantastic. Now this game is chock full of jams, and I'd show you guys an example, but Capcom would probably get mad at me. Just trust me, the music's good, the game looks good. As far as presentation goes, I really can't complain. However, the biggest problem with this game is the one that I have the hardest time excusing, and that is the runtime. The game is about 5 hours long, and normally I don't mind if a Resident Evil game is short. It's a game that scores you on your speed in the end. It is intended to be played fast and frequently. It normally has a lot of replayability, but I would say that this one kind of doesn't. I genuinely don't feel like there's anything worthwhile for me to go back and discover. They do have a lot of unlockables for you to collect after beating multiple runs, but I don't know. I don't really think I care. The last game had 4 routes with differences between all of them. And I get it, the original Resident Evil 3 didn't have multiple routes, so it wouldn't make sense if this one had multiple routes. But from what I do know, that game had this branching route system that slightly changed how things turned out. If they had kind of taken that and made it into something bigger in this game and actually made your choices matter, then I think this game would have been really cool and I would actually want to replay it to see what the other routes do. It just really seems a little weird to me that they would cut that, because I think that they probably were worried about how much content they could put into this $60 game. At $60, I think this game is just a little too lean for me. There's just not enough content for me personally, and yes, I know there is a free multiplayer mode, and I do appreciate that that is there. I think that's pretty cool. But as far as the base game goes, I'm a little disappointed. If this game was $40, I think half my criticisms would probably be invalid, but hey, that's just me. So, I'm gonna give Resident Evil 3 Remake a 6 out of 10.